In this video, I would like to talk about geophysics and how we use geophysics for site investigation. You probably heard like seismic methods for field and site investigation or geophysics. So I just want to give you some brief summary of what it's all about and how we can use the data from such investigation. So first of all, it's actually really good methods because it has a number of advantages. And one of them, it's inexpensive compared to borehole and other methods of investigation, SPT or other methods like field investigation or laboratory methods. This is actually, I would call it even cheap method of investigation. So that's one of the advantages. And the other advantage is that it can cover large areas. So if you know for boreholes, we have only one borehole. If we have a ground here, we have only one borehole, and we can only find out what is inside the borehole, what kind of rocks and properties of. You will see for geophysics, you can actually cover large areas. So let's look at this figure and see how this works. So we will need a special equipment. And the equipment is this geophones, the one that you stick in the ground. And usually the distance between geophones, it's about one, maybe 1.5 meters. We need to have a special device to register waves after we initiate elastic waves. And we need something actually to start the test, to initiate. So sometimes it's a large hammer. If we talk about larger areas of rocks, then we can have a small blast explosion. So we need something that will initiate elastic waves, and these waves will start traveling through this soil or rock mass. So you will see that it will travel in different directions. But if it goes through very hard stratum, like very hard rock, it will travel very, very fast. The velocity will be very fast compared to maybe soil or weathered rocks or weathered rocks with water. In this case, the velocity of these elastic waves will be pretty slow. So what we do in this test, we just measure how long it takes for waves to come to each of these geophones, and we're going to get lots of data. So we're going to accumulate data using this device. And the next step is to analyze the data, and from my experience, that's probably the most difficult part, because there is noise from waves and things like that. So we will need somebody who is really experienced, who's been doing this for many years, who can actually analyze the results and show us a change in the velocity of waves with depth. So that will be the final product that we can get from this test. So we're going to have a depth, and we're going to have a velocity. Velocity of this elastic waves that went through these geological units. So next step is to look at the velocity and try to interpolate them so that we can pick up the boundaries between different stratum, right? So again, this is interpolation. We try to be as accurate as possible. But in the end, it's still more or less assumption. So this is actually one of the disadvantages of this method, because we actually don't penetrate through the ground, so we don't get any samples. So we just get these velocities of seismic waves, and we'll try to analyze them. And we make assumption that for different geological units, there will be different velocities. Well, that's fine. It still works, but what we need to do, and that's one of the disadvantages, we will have to have borehole logs for that area. So you will see that we're going to get velocity 1,650 meters per second, but it doesn't say anything about geology. is that a rock? Is it weathered rock? Is it what in there? What kind of rock it is? We have no idea. What we only know is the velocity. Of course, with the velocities, we can try to estimate the strength of rocks, and this comes from lots of tests, from experiments in the laboratory and then in the field. So there is correlation between the velocity. You will see that when we have relatively low seismic velocities, the strength of the rock will be relatively high. So when the velocities go up, increase, you will see that the strength of the rock is also increasing. And we even have this classification for rocks: low strength rocks, medium strength, high strength rocks. Very often, 1 or 2 meters on the ground, it can be actually soil. So in this case, we also have to be careful. But as I mentioned before, what is important is we'll have a borehole. So that borehole will actually confirm our assumptions about the boundary. So we know that boundary here, and from borehole we can take a sample, and then we can find out that, for example, this rock is a granite, right? So in this case, we make assumption that this layer is granite. Without a borehole data, we cannot make such an assumption. But this is probably one of the biggest disadvantages. But if you use seismic methods together with borehole logs, that will be probably the best thing, because with these seismic methods, you can cover a large area. You see, borehole, you can only cover 1 point, 2 points, right? But together with seismic, you can cover large areas, and you can also save money. Well, thanks for watching this video. I hope it was informative. Have a nice day. Bye.